Bonjour. This is my most recent installment in my collaborative PowerPoint series. And today I'm going to talk about how my students use PowerPoint to create an ABC book. Now, the ABC book project is something I've done over the years, many different ways. And so this year is the first time I did it using PowerPoint, and the first year I did it in this particular way. The reason I like the concept of the ABC book is that it's a writing exercise that doesn't require a plot, really, and to write a story with a plot takes more writing skills than beginning students typically have in their first year. So by having a loose theme to tie all the elements together, students can write what they know, and they don't necessarily have to be too closely related. So the way I did this project was the students in the class all had to pick a theme for their ABC book. So the theme is something like animals, under the sea, dogs, cartoon characters. They have to pick some sort of theme. That's going to be the character that's going to, type of character that's going to appear on each slide. So what I would do is I would ask all the students to give me suggestions, and then all the students, even the ones in the room, would get on the Zoom call, and we, on the fly, I made a Zoom poll, and the students voted for their favorite, and that was their theme. So this particular class chose animated characters. So then the students, I put them in breakout groups on Zoom, combining students in the room with students at home so that I could go around and monitor the activity more easily. And then I gave each group two letters. And we were working on verbs, although I do often interchange verb and activity to help the students better understand what exactly a verb is. So I had them write a sentence using an animated character doing an action that begins with their assigned letter for the two slides that they were assigned. And they would write it right on the slide because they have editing rights to the PowerPoint. And if you want to learn about that, that is in my first video, how to give the students editing rights and how to do it safely. They didn't do any illustrations. They just went on the slide with the letter and wrote the sentence together in French. Now, we had already learned a bunch of verbs. And in my class, they don't really learn how to conjugate verbs fully. We mostly focus on first-person forms, and we don't use the word conjugate. But they're most familiar with first-person and third-person forms, which happen to also be spelled the same in a lot of instances. They also learned a bunch of expressions with je fais, and because we didn't go over the spelling of il or elle fait, I didn't include them in here, but basically I made an index of all the verbs that we had learned, and I added a few in because sometimes with certain letters there aren't that many and you want to give them some options. So this is for their reference. So they can make up a character or think of an animated character and say that that person is dancing. So then they went through and did all that. And then the next class, what I would do is I would assign each student a letter and they had to draw an illustration for that sentence. They were allowed to do it on paper and scan it, or do it on Paint 3D. Some students have personal devices where they can draw drawings like this. They can use the Sketchpad app on their iPad. They can actually draw right in PowerPoint. And while it doesn't have the cohesive same style, you can see that it is clearly a collaborative work. I also said if you wanted to say it in the first person, you want to say the character I say, they did write a little note in the corner of the slide that they wanted, say, Snoopy to be saying it. And then we take that out eventually and we put a speech bubble so we know that it's the character talking. So that took a few classes. And then what we did was, when this was finished, then also sometimes in certain classes, like if they pick something like Under the Sea, or one class picked food, they would want to say all these different foods that they hadn't learned. So I told them, write it in English, but put brackets around it. And that is like a heads up, they don't know how to say that. And then I would give them the extra terms. I generally discourage them from using a true dictionary at this level because they often don't know how to use it properly and end up picking the wrong word. So I just put through. So the under the sea group, they had a bunch of words they wanted to say, the food group, but then this class did the comic book characters and animated characters because they were not, you know, they were using a lot of proper nouns. They didn't really have anything they needed to look up. The next step was I wanted it to get narrated because I thought it would be cool to make it into a video. So I held a Zoom session. I did make it optional this year because the students in our model didn't have as much speaking practice as I would have liked. And I felt that there would be a lot of students that would just be really uncomfortable speaking, especially when they do it online. So I had a Zoom session and a few students volunteered their voices. And I set it to some music in a basic film editor on my computer at school, and I made it into a video. I also added English subtitles to the video so that people in the general public viewing it could follow along with the English in case the image didn't completely show exactly what the sentence said. The subtitles would clue you in. So that is the basis of this activity, and then of course I showed the final video. One thing I didn't mention is the reason we picked this one for the video is I didn't have every single classes get made into a video, and if you have more time and you wanted your students to narrate their class's video, that would be even better. What I did was the eighth grade students in the building actually voted on their favorite. They saw a PDF version of each product. Of each project, rather, and they voted. So this is the one that won, and that's why this one became the video. I would like to do this again next year, even if there are all my students are in the room. Using collaborative PowerPoint is great because if somebody's absent, everybody else still has access to the same project. And next year, I hope that we will be able to be in a setting that will allow the students more time and confidence to all be able to narrate the project together so we can publish all of them as YouTube videos. So if you go to my blog post, I'm going to link to some previous iterations of the project, and so you can see the evolution and see what versions of it might be most applicable to your classroom. Okay, au revoir.